California rock and roll. Today I am doing competition style chicken thighs on my slow smoker. It's a real simple concept. You just throw this in a marinator, solitary confinement, and we shut her down for about 2 days. We open her back up, take her out of the sarcophagus, and then we basically will put these dry on the grill, and then I'll make a little marinade with the tequila that it's been marinating in and some of the spice blend. And you can get this recipe, Gufinliars tequila lime chicken. And this is the competition style where it's slow cooked for several hours. You can also cook these on a grill with propane and do it in a matter of about 40 minutes. But this will take about 2.5 to 3 hours. To complement the competition style chicken thighs, we are also going to be doing a Amanda's cheesy potato dish, and that's recipe number 40 in the second book. And Amanda's my daughter in the book, and it's a whole thing you gotta get. Matter of fact, this is the book, second book. This is my first book, The Barbeque Joe Chronicles. And you can get both of them on Amazon. Just go to Amazon.com and then just put my name, Joe Svezia, spelled S-V-E-Z-I-A, and you'll be able to pull up the Barbeque Joe Chronicles 1 and 2. Rock and roll on that concept. I'm also doing a nice salad because we got the start of football season. We're kind of getting towards the end of the FedEx Cup for golf. So, you know, we're into that fall time. So I got a nice fall time arugula salad, and it's going to be rock and roll good, but nice and crisp. It's still kind of warm out. So a nice cool salad on a nice warm day like today to remind us of summer. We'll also be doing, from the second book, we'll be doing some of Dr. Idaho's jalapeno stuffed peppers. Now they are bosomed and good, just like Dr. Idaho. So you're going to want to try some of these bad boys. That's what we're doing tonight. And we will be grill side here within about the next 20 to 30 minutes. You can see we're doing an Alexander and Finch Merlot. This is out of Alexander Valley, Sonoma, and it's sub $12.99, kind of smooth. It's a nice smooth one. Anyway, so that's what we'll be doing tonight. So marinate often, grill responsibly, and we'll see you grill side here in just a few minutes.
Okay, folks, we are grill side. And these have been on about 30 minutes. They're going to stay on about another two and a half hours. So we'll do them about 3 hours. But just look at those Indians surrounding that wagon. That is just beautiful. And that is going to be tender, moist, and flavorful because we're doing it at a very low temperature. As you can see, it'll heat back up once the lid's closed, back up to about 220. And we'll keep it there for the remainder of the time. We'll finish it off with a nice finishing glaze. And this will be one memorable chicken. Okay, we've been on just about an hour and 15 minutes now. You can see we're staying real consistent at that 220. And that's what we're looking like. So at this point, we're going to go ahead and we're going to turn these bad boys over. Oh yeah, look at how moist those things are on the bottom. See, I like to brown the skin on the top before I turn anything over. And then we'll keep them in the upside down position for a good 45 minutes to an hour. And then we'll bring it back over and we'll start shooting some glaze on it. Some finishing glaze. Now it's time for a little bit of glaze. It's been on about, hour and 45 minutes. We're going to keep it on just about another hour. I'm going to put a little glaze on these just to help keep them moist. They are just beautiful. You can see, I've got my jalapeno peppers on. She's naturally drop dead gone.